Hi, I'm Ashwarya. I'm a postdoctoral researcher at VMware Research. Today, I'm going to be presenting a work on exploiting the Linux vulnerability for fast application storage. As Lamson famously stated, defining interfaces is the most important part of system design. This is because well-designed interfaces often lead to desirable properties. For example, idempotent interfaces make failure recovery simpler. Similarly, interfaces that are commutative enable scalable software implementation. In a similar spirit, in this work, we ask, do some storage interfaces enable higher performance than others? Our exercise in answering this question led us to identify an important interface property in storage systems, which we call Nilix tunnelity. A Nilix tunnelizing, or in short, a Nilix interface, can modify the storage system state in any way, but it does not externalize the effects of the operation or the system state immediately. Therefore, a system can defer executing a Nilix operation, thereby improving performance. And it turns out that Nilix interfaces are quite prevalent in storage systems. Given the advantages of Nilix interfaces, in this work, we exploit Nilix tunnelity to build fast replicated storage. Current replication protocols are oblivious to storage interfaces. Replicas coordinate to agree on the ordering for all updates, and this is expensive and incurs store on trips. We thus build Skiros, a Nilix-aware replication protocol. The main insight in Skiros is to defer coordination until the state is externalized. Since Nilix operations do not externalize state, Skiros defers their ordering until the state is externalized and completes Nilix updates in one round trip. Similar to Paxos, Skiros provides reversibility, but it incurs significantly lower latencies. That was the introduction to the talk. In the rest of the talk, I'll give a background on strongly consistent storage. I'll then present the key ideas and the results. Let's look at the standard approach today to building a strongly consistent system. Suppose you want to make a local storage engine like RocksDB fault tolerant. You start with this local storage engine and then layer a consensus protocol like Paxos on top of it. And what you essentially get is a fault tolerant RocksDB. Now you have replicated copies of RocksDB running and a consensus layer coordinating the operations to the database state. And this layer ensures that all replicas execute the same sequence of operations, ensuring reversibility. For example, Facebook's CPDB and HARP are built in this manner. A storage system built using this standard approach has high overheads. Let's see why. Usually in these systems, one of the replicas is called the leader and the others are called the followers. Each replica has something called a log. Let's suppose you want to apply multiple updates to this too. The clients send the request to the leader. The leader assigns an order for these operations, persists them to the log, replicates them to the followers. Followers add these operations to their logs and acknowledge the leader. Once a majority of replicas have acknowledged, the operations are durable and won't be lost. The system has now also established an order for these requests and this order won't change. So at this point, the leader can execute these updates and return the results. Updates thus involve multi-round trip agreement and such multiple network round trips can hamper system performance. So before we go into how Nilix aware replication addresses this problem, let's take a closer look at Nilix interfaces. As I mentioned earlier in the talk, a Nilix interface may modify the storage system state in any way. The operation can be a blind overwrite or a read modify write. However, it does not externalize the system state by returning an execution result or an error. The interface can still return an acknowledgement indicating request completion. Put interface in the key value API is an example of a Nilix operation. Put returns only an ACK and does not return any error, for example, by checking if the key is present. So are these Nilix interfaces practical? It turns out that Nilix interfaces are not just practical, they are also prevalent. First, almost all updates are Nilix in popular write-optimized stores like RocksDB and MemoryDB. Let's take a closer look at the interfaces. As I told you earlier, put is Nilixed and so is multiport. Even deletes are Nilixed because a delete does not return an error if the key being deleted is absent. Rather, just a tombstone message is inserted and the operation is acknowledged. Surprisingly, even read modify writes are also Nilix in these systems. A read modify write is implemented using something called a merge operator. And this merge operation is not applied immediately. Rather, a message is inserted that specifies how to modify the value associated with the key. So as you can see, all updates are NULLX in these stores. This is because these stores are designed to avoid queries before updates. Of course, GET exposes tape and is non-NULLXed. However, some systems have a mix of NULLXed and non-NULLXed interfaces. But production traces reveal that a vast majority of updates issued by applications are NULLXed. Please see our paper for the analysis. Now let's take a look at how we can exploit these NULLX interfaces for fast replication. To recall, the problem with consistent replication is that updates incur multiple network round trips. So how do we avoid these overheads? Our first insight is that to achieve durability, you don't need to coordinate among replicas. The clients can directly write the updates to the replicas. But ordering is expensive and requires coordination. So is it possible to defer ordering? Yes. We realize that it's indeed possible to defer ordering if the update is NULLXed. Since a NULLX update does not externalize the system state immediately, it can be ordered and applied lazily. Since the updates are NULLXed here, the replicas respond to the clients without ordering and complete the request in one RTT. However, later non-NULLX operations may externalize the effects of these NULLX operations. For instance, a read to a piece of data modified by a NULLX update. So the NULLX updates must be still applied in the same order across replicas, and this should be enforced before its state is externalized. But this is not detrimental to performance because background work ensures that these updates have already been executed by the time the application issues a state externalizing operation. So as you can see, this read can be completed quickly. Our core idea is to defer work until the state is externalized. This general idea of deferring work has proven beneficial in other contexts, such as programming languages, file systems, and databases. However, in this work, we apply this general idea in the context of replication to hide the cost of ordering. More importantly, our work also identifies an interface level property in storage systems that enables deferring work. Based on the insights I just described, we designed Skiros, a new replication protocol. Skiros is based on VR, and similar to VR, it's leader-based. It provides the same guarantees as VR, but at better performance. Now let's take a look at how Skiros processes different requests. Clients send NULLX updates directly to the replicas and make them durable in one round trip. The leader then orders and executes these updates in the background. Reads go to the leader, and if there are no pending updates to the object being read, the leader returns the result of the read immediately, thus completing the read in one round trip. Sometimes reads incur two round trips. If the leader finds that if there are pending updates to the object being read that have not yet been ordered, the leader synchronously executes and orders and executes these updates before returning the result of the read. When updates expose state, they take two round trips as well. So we have both one and two round trip operations in our protocol. However, real world traces show that fast case is the common case. The previous slide just showed the overview of the protocol. In the paper, we discuss several techniques in Skiros' design that ensures both correctness and performance. Skiros, for instance, employs the durability log and supermajority quorums to complete NULLX writes in one round trip. It uses an ordering and execution check to serve reads in one round trip. It has techniques to ensure correctness during view changes. We also build a variant of Skiros that exploits commutativity in addition to NULLX tenability. I encourage you to read the paper for the details. Now let's take a look at some results. So what are the benefits of exploiting NULLX tenability? To answer this question, we compare Skiros against Paxos with and without patching for an NULLX only workload varying the number of clients. And we plot the latencies against the throughputs. With patching, Paxos achieves more throughput. Skiros matches the high throughput of patching, but it incurs significantly lower latencies compared to Paxos because it can commit NULLX requests in one round trip. In the paper, we have more results from extensive benchmarks. This is showing significant gains for light heavy versus heavy workloads, tail latency improvements for read heavy workloads, and experiments comparing Skiros with the commutative protocol. To summarize, we identify nil externality, a property prevalent in storage systems, and design a new replication protocol, Skiros, that improves performance for a range of workloads while providing data accessibility. More broadly, our work shows how paying attention to what is observable to end clients is key. This offers opportunities to lazily enforce constraints when needed. More importantly, our work shows that it's useful to exploit the properties of an underlying layer at the layers above. In particular, current replication protocols are oblivious to the underlying storage interfaces, resulting in missed performance opportunities. Our work shows that by making the replication layer aware of the underlying storage interface properties, we can realize high performance. With that, I conclude my talk. Thank you.